Hi, welcome back. We are touching on an old school topic today. I feel as if I'm far enough in my YouTube career where I'm just gonna go ahead and call myself an expert on Pattern Foundation. It's what I based my channel off of. It's what thousands of you all have subscribed to me for. And I realize in the past few years, I've really kind of died down on the Pattern Foundation content, and that's because I think I've been making videos for like 8 years now, which is crazy to even say out loud. I felt like I was at a point to where I had talked about everything I could possibly talk about in regards to Pattern Foundation. However, I realize there are several of you who are discovering me from those old videos, and you may not necessarily know that I have literally dozens upon dozens upon dozens of troubleshooting videos when it comes to wearing Pattern Foundation. So, what I thought I would do in today's video is just lay out a do's and a don'ts. And this is going to mainly be a big recap on all of the videos I've made in the past. I will try to link down below the most helpful videos that I've done in regards to troubleshooting your Pattern Foundation. But I thought this would be a good compilation to literally just lay out what you should be doing and what you shouldn't be doing and why you might be unhappy when you wear Pattern Foundation by itself. So, just a quick, literally 5 or 6 things we're gonna run through. I'm gonna talk about what you shouldn't be doing and then kind of move into what you should be doing instead. 9 times out of 10, this is why people are unhappy with the way their Pattern Foundation looks. It is generally the culprit for having a super powdery face, a face that literally looks like you're only wearing powder on top of it, and that is not taking the proper amount of time to buff your Pattern Foundation in. And let me explain why this is so important. I'm going to use Bare Minerals Original Powder Foundation as an example because I think it is the superior formula out of all powder foundations. You know, it has been my personal favorite for nearly 10 years now. The reason you have to take the time to buff into the skin is because this starts out as a powder, but once it is warmed up by buffing, it actually emulsifies and turns into a cream. So this is why I used to get comments on my videos saying, "There's no way you're just wearing a powder foundation. How does it look so creamy? How does it look like a liquid essentially?" And that's because it does turn into a cream. Once you have buffed it enough, once it has mixed with the natural oils on your skin, this will turn into a really nice, soft, creamy finish. So, a big misconception is that, let's say, for example, when people want to get started with Pattern Foundation and maybe they see like an ad for a Bare Minerals starter kit, they think it's a one-stop shop, like you just throw it on and you're done and you're out the door. You can totally do that, but if you're really wanting a nice, like, collected look that actually looks like liquid makeup, you truly have to take the time to buff into your skin. So I probably buff for a good 60 seconds before I ever go back and get more powder. I mean, I'm talking like when there's nothing left on my brush, I'm still working to buff that in. And it doesn't take a long time. I mean, truthfully, it takes no more time than it would to blend out a traditional, like, medium coverage foundation. So if you haven't been aware of that and you've just kind of been throwing it on and running out the door, you're just gonna have the powder sitting on top of your skin. It doesn't emulsify. It doesn't end up looking creamy. It really kind of just looks like dry, chalky powder on the skin. So that's my number one tip. I promise you start doing this, you will notice a huge difference. The second mistake people make is using too much product. And this kind of falls along the lines of what I just talked about as far as powder sitting on top of the skin. When you use too much of the powder on your brush, it doesn't give the powder the chance to warm up and to emulsify and to look creamy and to blend into the skin. So I take the smallest amount of product and work little by little to build up my coverage. That way, it ensures everything is super blended, really soft looking on the skin. You also end up saving more product. It ends up lasting you longer. I can't tell you how many people, when I used to actually work for Bare Minerals in college, I had people who would come in and buy the powder foundation weekly. That's how much powder they were using. And, you know, when I explained to them, like, hey, a little really does go a long way as long as you're properly applying it, it was a game changer. So make sure you're not dumping a ton of product into your lid. And even if you did try to blend all of that out and work, you know, 60 seconds with each application, by using too much product, it just, again, like I said, it doesn't give it the chance to really melt into the skin. So this doesn't really fall into a don't category. It is definitely a do category, but it is a question I get asked often, and that is, can I wear creams or liquids with powder foundation? Most of the time, people are referring to like cream concealer. And absolutely, this was, I feel like, definitely a common myth when powder foundation started becoming popular that you couldn't really use like a cream concealer with it. I actually love mixing powders and creams together. I love mixing those mediums because it adds a really nice definition and dimension to the skin. So I'm wearing a cream concealer. I'm wearing the Bare Minerals Bare Pro concealer with the powder today. I prefer to use it on top of my powder. You can do it either way. You just have to experiment and see which way works best for you, see which way looks best on your skin. And not only concealer, I would highly encourage the use of, let's say, like a cream blush or a cream bronzer. I think, again, it really adds life to the skin. A problem a lot of people encounter when they're just using all powder is that their face looks a little flat. So I'm actually wearing a cream concealer and a cream blush on my cheeks today. You can see I've got a little bit of glow going on, and that's coming from that cream product that's placed on top of the powder. I think powder foundation is one of the most resilient foundations as far as longevity goes throughout the day. And so cream products, if you've buffed it in and it's really attached to your skin well, it's not going to disturb the base at all. So like I said, I highly encourage kind of mixing different mediums because you ultimately get a little bit more of a hyper-realistic look. So this next recommendation may shock a few of you because for any other makeup routine, like liquid or cream that I'm using, BB cream, foundation, I am a strong advocate for just using your moisturizer or something really nice and luminous and moisturizing underneath as a base. I don't think you have to use a ton of primers to get the desired effect that you want. Unless you have, let's say, enlarged pores or scarring, then I think silicone primers can really be a benefit. But when it comes to powder foundation, I think that this is one foundation product or base product that really does excel with a primer underneath it, and especially silicone based primers. So an example would be the primer that Bare Minerals actually makes for their powder foundation. That works phenomenally well underneath the makeup. And I think it really, again, it just kind of adds to helping speed up that creamy like process when it mixes with a little bit of the primer. You just get that quicker cream skin-like finish. And I know I'm referring to Bare Minerals a lot in this video, and that's mainly because it is my personal favorite, but this can apply to any type of powder that you're using. I just feel as if a primer really does benefit a powder foundation. I think that it can just kind of like bump it up to the next level. Quicker coverage, I always find when I use a primer with my powder. Again, it helps with the emulsifying process, and just overall, I think it's a good companion for powder foundation. And especially, like I said, I really do prefer those silky, like silicone-based primers. I don't necessarily reach for like the liquid illuminating type primers. I really kind of stick with those that have a really good reputation for just smoothing out the skin. So this is my final tip, and it has everything to do with brushes and the type of brush that you're using. For years, I've been asked, like, do I have to buy a specific powder foundation foundation brush for my powder. And truthfully, it all depends on the type of powder that you're using. If you are using something loose, I would highly suggest something like what Bare Minerals markets with theirs, which is called the Beautiful Finish Brush. This one is my personal favorite. A lot of people, and I have recommended Real Techniques in the past, it will get the job done. But when you're using something, let's say like this Real Techniques blush brush, which a lot of people use for powder, it's not dense enough to build up coverage. So you just want to make sure that you're using something that's dense. I've seen people say that they like to use the Bare Minerals Expert Face Brush. This for me has never done the trick. I have never found that it's been able to blend and activate the foundation as well as something like this. And they are made out of completely different fibers. I think they're both synthetic, but the Bare Minerals one, they use some particular type of fiber, whereas the Real Techniques is kind of like that traditional synthetic feel that you're used to. I'm not crazy about this particular brush with the foundation, but again, it's kind of a trial and error process. I would just recommend something that is on the medium dense to dense side. So, I mean, even this Beautiful Finish brush, it's not super densely packed, but something about the fibers, whatever this brush is made out of, it really does a phenomenal job of buffing and melting the product into the skin. So with your brush, I would just say make sure it's not too loose. And if you're using something that is really synthetic right now and you're not happy with the finish, definitely try looking into different fibers. Try looking into different brands that maybe make specific brushes for powder foundation. And I think you'll find eventually something that's gonna work for you. But in regards to when I get asked, like, is it essential to splurge on, you know, an expensive powder foundation brush? Sometimes it is for certain people and sometimes it isn't. I feel like that's definitely a preference thing. But for me personally, the Beautiful Finish, this has been my favorite since they came out with it. Okay, those are the things that I wanted to address. Those are the main culprits. Those are the issues I feel that people commonly have and I still get questions about. If you need further assistance, I do have, like I said, dozens of videos throughout the past years. I'm gonna look a lot different in those videos because we've been knowing that I look different every single year. I can't keep the same look. I can't keep the same hair. So just know it is still me in the videos that I'm recommending. You know, I've just been doing this for so long that it's just crazy to even think that I have this many videos out there, but I always want to provide references and things that you can look back on. And I just feel like this is a really quick compilation that can help you target some things you might be experiencing. But like I said, I'll have everything I've talked about previously listed down below, why your foundation doesn't look good, why your powder foundation doesn't look good. I have a video talking about how to use pressed powder foundation. I have a video talking about, you know, like the proper way to apply loose powder foundation. So I should have a video covering most topics in regards to powder foundation. So hope you enjoyed this. If you have any questions, leave them down below and I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye.